Hi, this is Commissioner Doug Underhill, and I'm standing here in the National Naval Aviation Museum, and soon we'll be going over to the National Flight Academy. And we've got a really special day here today because we've got a group of Warrington middle school kids who are going to basically spend, this is what their school day looks like. Now you could live just about anywhere else in the world and not be able to do a day trip to go watch the Blue Angels fly. And the reason that we're doing this is to really demonstrate to these kids, you know, it's very easy to talk down about Escambia County, it's easy to talk down about Warrington, and certainly there are a lot of things that we've got to change and do better about. But if you're a kid growing up in Warrington, you've got to understand that you are surrounded by exceptionalism. The Navy Blue Angels are the best warriors of the sky that the world has ever seen in the entire history of the world. So here is this exceptional team that demonstrates teamwork and dedication and hard work in ways that no other team can. And they could live and work anywhere in the United States of America. Where do they choose to live? Right here in Pensacola, Florida, right here in Warrington, where they got started. Now, if Warrington can give birth to the Blue Angels, it can give birth to anything. And what we're trying to do here today, and I think that when these kids walk out of here today, I hope they have just a glimmer of the idea that not only can Warrington do anything, but that kid from Warrington can do anything. This is an investment in the future. So come along with us and have a good time.
Is we're fortunate to have the support of some of our community leaders here. Commissioner Underhill here is a great supporter. You're going to see a movie today. You're going to see a movie on the big screen, the IMAX. Anybody, you have any idea how big that screen is? 66 by 82. Okay. You're going to see this great big movie screen, all right? And he helped us get that film in here for y'all. And for the rest of the community. You know how many people come through here in a year? Almost 900,000. All right? You know the most important people that come here every year? Raise your hand. It's you guys. Okay? This is why we're here. It's so that you can learn, so that you can see it, and that you can gain the benefit of one, living here, and two, all the advantage of things that there are to learn and discover here, okay?
I'm new to politics, so I'm not going to talk to you like a politician. I'm going to talk to you like somebody who lives here and just want you to understand why it was important to me to have Warrington Middle School kids and Warrington kids come through this place. It's easy looking around Warrington to think, nobody cares about this place. We're not important people from an important place. Okay, so our horizons are smaller than other people. But I'm going to tell you right now, that is not true. Anybody here heard of the Tuskegee Airmen? Okay, these guys came from worse conditions than you did, and when they were given the opportunity to excel, they excelled. Okay, so it's our job as society to give you guys the opportunity to excel. But guys, it's your job to figure out what it was you were put here on Earth to be exceptional at. There is something on this earth that you were designed to be exceptional about, okay? You're gonna go and you're gonna see the Blue Angels fly today. You're gonna see them up close and personal. And then after that, you're going to meet members of the Blue Angels team. Guys, don't just focus on the pilots, because let me tell you, a pilot that doesn't have an aircraft that's ready to do the things you see today is just a pretty boy in a flight suit, okay? It takes a lot of people and a lot of jobs to make this kind of exceptionalism happen. Now, Warrington gave birth to the Blue Angels. It happened right here. They are the best that the world has ever seen, and it came out of Warrington. And when they got great, they could have gone somewhere else. You don't think there's 100 communities in America that would love to have all the Blue Angels their own? But they're right here in Warrington. Okay? If Warrington has the ability to give birth to something so great as the Blue Angels and maintain it for so many years, then there really is no limit to the horizons that you guys have got. And I'm going to tell you right now, aviation and what you're going to see in this IMAX film today, aviation has expanded our horizons by shrinking the world. There is nothing in this world that you can't get to within about a 12-hour flight from here. So it doesn't matter where you're coming from anymore. What matters is where you're going. Okay? Been a lot of focus in Escambia County on things other not so important to folks like you. Things are changing in this county. You've got a government that listens more. And I know this is starting to sound like that politics stuff, but What you have to understand is that we as grown-ups understand it's our job to give you the opportunity to get to those horizons. It's your job to figure out which horizon you're going after. So I hope that today, if you walk out of here thinking, man, I saw something I could do, all right, then you go after it. If you walk out of here today seeing things that don't make any sense to you or none of that seems like something I want to be a part of, you need to find what does excite you and then chase that down. And don't let other people tell you the reason you go to school is so you can get a 3 or better on the FCAT. Okay? 3 or better on the FCAT doesn't mean a thing to you as kids. I want to know what your dream is, where do you want to go, and then it's our job as society and the school system to give you the tools that you need to get there. So enjoy your trip here today. It's a lot better than sitting in class. You guys will learn. I learn a lot more from a place like this than I do in a classroom. So enjoy your stay, guys.
So the National Flight Academy and the National Naval Aviation Museum approached me in my role as the county commissioner to help fund the new IMAX film, Living in the Age of Airplanes. It really talks more about, talks about aviation from a kind of a different angle in that how it made the world so much smaller and in doing so expanded all of our horizons. So we helped fund this and bring this to the museum, and if I'm not mistaken, it debuted here the same day that it debuted at the Smithsonian. So you're really kind of one of those things you don't think about Pensacola sometimes as being cutting edge and out front, but in fact, in this case, we are. But part of that agreement was that the museum would reach out to the local kids at Warrington Middle School, bring them in here, let them show them the film. You know, many of these kids who live blocks away from this place have never been in here before. Of course, General Thiessen and his crew jumped on the opportunity, and so those kids are going to have a very inspirational and awesome visit. They're going to see the Blue Angels fly. They get to go and actually meet some of the team that supports the Blue Angels after the show. That'll be a day at school any day.
The only thing that would improve our house, the only thing that would improve the experience here is if we could get the commissioner to be one of our docents and guide people through, because he'd be really good at it.
In my spare time. And actually, General, I don't think I could compete with these guys that you see walking around in the blue jackets, because a lot of these guys actually flew the aircraft that they're talking about and showing to you. This is a living museum.
It is. And I tell everybody that there's kind of... One metaphor is a three-legged stool. There are three points of strength here. Obviously, I'm from the foundation, and we have a lot to do to support the museum. But I tell you what, the director and his staff who move the aircraft around and who manage the floor, and then our volunteers. We have this huge group of volunteers, and the number is in excess of 400. They're not all here at any one time, and some of them are seasonal, but we have this pool of volunteers who are the face that meets the public first, and they are just fantastic. For them, it's a identity experience. For them, it's a social experience. For them, it's a point of pride, and they're part of our community in the process, and they are just absolutely wonderful assets to this museum.
Yeah, there's no question they absolutely set the tone when you walk in the door. You are instantly a part of the process, right, because of the way that they greet you. You know, you mentioned the volunteers, and I think it's important that people understand also, how many U.S. tax dollars went into building this place and operating it?
Zero.
Not a single one.
None. Now, the government owns the ground. The government owns the ground, and the government has a small paid staff here. But all the rest of this is done through sponsorship and donations and gifting and support from those who want to help us preserve and display and convey the history of the United States through the role of naval aviation in that history.
There are a couple of very inspirational buildings in Escambia County, and this is one of them. If you walk through this place and you are not inspired, you need to take another lap, and you will be.
Yeah. It doesn't matter where people come from. We have something to offer them. It's always heartwarming when we have some of the older gentlemen come in here who will stop and look at an aircraft, and they pause and they reflect because they're remembering and they're associating with what's going on there.
This place doesn't exist because some government office right. decided to make this happen. It's just because a bunch of people of like mind and like energy got together and said, we should do this, and then wouldn't take no for an answer.
That's right. That's right. It's good to have you here.
Always a pleasure.
Thank you very much.
All right, thank you.
Well, it's a nice field trip to get the students out and experience what Naval Aviation provides, and they get to see a tour of the Naval Air Museum, the Flight Academy, as well as they get a little demonstration of the Blue Angels. Everyone loves to see the Blue Angels. Well, the message is if they do really well in school and they get good grades, and I think they could that'd be a good message for them to, you know, if you do really well, this is your incentive. This is what you can go do if you do good. Yes, I was here once when I was a student, the school that I'm teaching at now, 15 years ago, and it's good to come back, go full circle, and be a part of it again, this time as an instructor. And I got to help a little bit of the schools back then. I love helping schools, being a part of the community, and I feel that I'm making a big impact and doing my part.
So this day for these kids from Warrington was enabled in part by a county sponsorship and partnership with the National Flight Academy and the National Naval Aviation Museum to bring a new IMAX film called Living in the Age of Airplanes. It's hosted by Harrison Ford, phenomenal, just exciting movie about not just military aircraft, but what aircraft and aviation in general has done to really shrink the world. And in shrinking the world to grow the possibilities for kids like these kids right here in Warrington.
During the year we learn about different aspects of flight. We learn, you know, how planes fly, we know how they work. We have flight simulators at the school, so they have experience in virtual flying. And today was kind of an end of year incentive, you know, give them a taste of, come out and see what the aviation's all about. So we had a lot of good things going on today, because, you know, we put this together with the keeping their interest in mind, but yeah, a lot of the reactions have just been, you know, really good. It's almost like, you know, best day ever kind of a thing. So I think by and large they're all getting something out of it. Anytime you apply a lesson out in the real world, it reaches back to them. It makes it I think it makes it more important to them. Makes them understand a lot more why they have to do certain things. And so, you know, and knowing, you know, like the film was, you know, paid for here, knowing that we have the people working and the Blue Angels and everything, and it helps them give them a sense of community. So the community really came together to put this day together for our kids, through our PTSA, through the NATC, and the Flight Academy, and everybody worked together to give our kids an opportunity. It did not cost them a penny out of their own pockets to come out here today. Yeah, I mean, we were seeing some big changes, and a lot of it, I think, really does have to do with, like I said, community involvement. You go back a number of years ago, they used to say it takes a village to raise a child, and, you know, it seemed really cliche at the time, but, you know, it really does. And, we have a great staff, a great faculty at our school. We all work together as a team, and we have great community support from our PTSA. So, and then, of course, the commissioner was out here this morning, too, so... You know, that shows how important it is for a community to work together for education. I think the biggest thing I really want them to get out of it is the fact that we have this community that cares about them, and that they're important to somebody. And, like I said, people care. I just want them to feel important. I want them to feel loved. I want them to really feel like that somebody is there to support them.
So I hope everybody has enjoyed their quick tour following these kids around through the National Flight Academy and the National Naval Aviation Museum. If you haven't physically gotten into this place, we all know this is one of the top tourist destinations here in the Panhandle. But you don't have to be a tourist to come and enjoy it. How much does it cost to get in? Absolutely nothing. This place is not paid for by tax dollars. It's paid for by donations of the people who built it. And it was done with the intent for it always to be free. So come on down and have a look at it. If you walk through these spaces and you don't walk out of here inspired, then walk through it again, because you're missing something.